Hi, hello friends, welcome to my channel Tutelage. So today we are going to see exercise 5.6 in your chapter Understanding Elementary Shapes. So before getting into the sum, you should know some triangles. Okay, if in a triangle all the sides are equal means that is an equilateral triangle. Okay, two sides are equal and one side is of different length means that is isosceles triangle. Okay, then all the three sides are of different length means that is scalen triangle. Then if the triangle or one angle is less than 90 degree means it is acute angled triangle. If it is greater than 90 degree means then it is obtuse angled triangle. So these are the triangles that you should know. So first let us see the second sum and then we will see the first sum, because second sum I wrote it on the board, that's why. Okay, now let's get into the video. So match the following. This is the measure of triangle and this is the types of triangle. Three sides of equal length. So three sides of equal length, all the lengths are equal. So it is nothing but equilateral triangle. Okay. Two sides of equal length. If two sides means it is isosceles triangle. How you remember means keep it as two eyes. So two sides means two eyes, it is isosceles triangle. Okay, so it is isosceles triangle. All sides of different length. So sides are of different length. Okay, that is scalen triangle. Okay, next one, three acute angle. Acute angle they themselves give. So it is acute angled triangle. It is four. Then one right angle. Right angle is nothing but your 90 degree, that is right angled triangle. This is five. Okay, one obtuse angle. One obtuse angle is nothing but obtuse angled triangle. Six. Next one, one right angle with two sides of equal length. So that is nothing but isosceles triangle. Two sides are of equal length. I said two sides, two eyes, isosceles triangle. So it is seven. Isosceles triangle. So now let's move on to the first sum. This is your second sum. Now we will see the first sum. So this is your first sum in your exercise. Name the types of following triangles. So you are going to name the types of following triangles. Okay, first one, a triangle with length of sides 7 cm, 8 cm and 9 cm. You see the sides are of different length in all the three cases. That is all the three sides. Okay, that is 7 cm, 8 cm and 9 cm. So what you are going to do, it is, what triangle it is? It is a scalen triangle. Okay, so the answer is scalen triangle. All the three sides are unequal. Okay. Next one, triangle ABC with AB equal to 8.7 cm, AC is equal to 7 cm and BC is equal to 6 cm. Here also of different length, so again it is nothing but a scalen triangle. Okay, triangle PQR such that PQ equal to QR equal to PR equal to 5 cm. All the three sides is of 5 cm, so it is nothing but what triangle? Equilateral triangle. Okay. Triangle DEF with angle D as 90 degree. So if it is 90 degree, then it is what triangle? Right angled triangle. Okay. Next one, triangle XYZ with angle Y equal to 90 degree and XY equal to YZ. Two sides are equal, that means it is an isosceles triangle and also this one angle is 90 degree. So we can say right angled isosceles triangle. Okay. Right angled isosceles triangle. Okay, next one, triangle LMN with angle C equal to 30 degree, angle M equal to 70 degree, angle N equal to 80 degree. You see this angle C is 30 degree, so it is nothing but acute angle triangle. It is also less than 90, this is all the three angles are less than 90, so it is acute angle triangle. Now let's move on to a third sum. So this is your next sum, that is a third sum. They ask you to name each of the following triangles in two different ways. Okay. In two different ways you have to name the triangle. And also you may judge the nature of angle by observation. Just by looking you can say what triangle it is. See, the first triangle is having 5 cm, 5 cm and 8 cm. Okay, so that is two sides are equal. That is nothing but isosceles triangle. Isosceles, and then see two angles are equal, and also it is less than 90 degree. So it is nothing but acute angled triangle. Isosceles and then acute angled triangle. So in two ways we wrote. Okay, then see right angle 90 degree. It is, so it is right angled triangle, and then all the three sides are different length. Okay, so it is scale length triangle. Okay, here two sides are equal, so it is isosceles triangle, and then the angle is greater than 90 degrees, so it is obtuse angled triangle. Okay, next 10 cm, 10 cm, two sides are equal, so it is isosceles triangle. See 90 degree, it is right angled triangle. See, all the three sides are equal. If all the three sides are equal, it is equilateral triangle. Okay, see, all the three sides are different. So, it is equilateral triangle, and also it is acute angled triangle. Okay, next one. See, all the three sides are different. So, it is scale length triangle. And then, this angle is greater than 90 degrees. So, it is obtuse angled triangle. Okay, so this is your third sum. Now we will go on to the last sum, fourth sum in this exercise. So, fourth sum, I will read it out for you. Okay, try to construct triangles using matchsticks. So, using matchsticks, we are going to construct the triangle. Okay, sum are shown here. Can you make a triangle with 3 matchsticks? 4 matchsticks, 5 and 6. So, with 3, 4, 5 and 6, you are going to make a triangle. And then, remember, you have to use all available matchsticks in each case. You have to use all the matchsticks in each case. If you cannot make a triangle, then think of a reason for it. Suppose using the matchstick, you are not able to make a triangle. You have to say the reason for it. Okay. Now, first, let's take 3 matchsticks and form a triangle. So, you know, a triangle is made up of 3 sides. So, using 3 matchsticks, this is the first matchstick, second matchstick, third matchstick. I made a triangle using 3 matchsticks. If you find means, answer is nothing but with 3 matchsticks, I made a triangle. This is an acute angled triangle, and it is possible with 3 matchsticks to make a triangle because sum of two sides is greater than the third side, which is the applicable property for triangles. Sum of two sides is greater than the third sides. Okay. Then with 4 matchsticks. With 4 matchsticks, are you able to make a triangle? No, I am able to make only a square or parallelogram. Okay, so with 4 matchsticks, it is not possible to make a triangle. Then with 5 matchsticks. See, I formed one triangle here, two triangle here. This is inverted triangle, this is straight triangle. Okay, with 5 matchsticks, so your answer is, this is also an acute angled triangle. Okay, and it is possible to make triangle with 5 matchsticks. In this case also, sum of two sides is greater than the third side. You have to write this statement. That's why I am reading it out to you. Okay. Next one, it is 6 matchsticks. I am keeping the points here. This is 1 matchstick till here. Okay. Then 2, 3 matchsticks. 4, 5. Here one more dot, 6 matchsticks. So using, see, this is 1 matchstick, this is 2 matchstick, 3rd matchstick, 4th matchstick, 5th matchstick, 6th matchstick. So using 6 matchsticks, you can form a triangle, and also the sum of two sides is greater than the third side, and this is also an acute angled triangle. So this is your answer. So with this, your exercise 5.6 is completed. If you like my video, please like, share, subscribe and comment, and click the bell button without fail. Okay, thank you friends. Thanks for watching. Bye.